Welcome to NAFC-TV's Moving Forward. I'm Diane Williamson. Recently, one of our educators, Geradine Schultze, was honored with an Imagine Award presented by Rauch Incorporated in recognition of her efforts to make our community and our world better for people with disabilities. Geradine is the Preschool Early Intervention Coordinator at the Children's Academy Early Learning Center.
We are the first step into education when a child turns three. If there's any type of special needs, it's our obligation to provide services to that child. So that any child that's born with special needs or through whatever circumstance needs speech therapy, occupational physical therapy, they can get early intervention. And early intervention is so key. We see children, the day they turn three, they begin services here until kindergarten. And all the research leads to the importance of early intervention, and we see children that begin non-verbally and go into kindergarten with no support, no special ed support. So that's our goal for every child, not to need any special education support. Certainly we lay a plan for kindergarten. The speech therapist, occupational and physical therapist, teacher of the deaf, teacher of the blind and low vision, all work collaboratively with the teaching assistants, even the cafeteria staff. Everyone works to develop communication skills, fine motor, gross motor skills, and so forth.
Geradine told me about one of the many success stories coming out of Children's Academy.
We had a little boy named Sammy, and when he came to us, his parents were concerned maybe he had autism. He was not speaking. He had just started speaking a little bit before his third birthday. This year, we exited him from special education. He's speaking and acting like every other five-year-old ready for kindergarten, and he'll go to kindergarten without any special education support.
With success stories like that, how does it feel as she's driving home at the end of the day?
Rewarding. Rewarding. I think we're blessed in that. I'm going to get choked up. can you turn me? That we have made a difference in children's lives. That, I guess, when people ask educators what do they do or what do they make, we make a difference. We really do make a difference for our young kids.
Congratulations are also in order for New Albany High School junior William Taylor, who won first place in this year's Congressional Art Competition. His portrait painting will be shipped to Washington, D.C., where it will hang in a student art exhibit in the tunnels that run beneath the Capitol building, representing the 9th Congressional District. Later this summer, he'll be honored in a ceremony along with other student artists from across the nation. If you know about something great happening at your school, please let me know. And for details on these and other stories, check out our website and our Facebook page. You can also follow us on Twitter at NAFC Success. I'm Diane Williamson, and we'll see you next time on Moving Forward.